Having received the Art in the Archive bursary, inviting me as an artist to engage with the Women's Art Library, I created an abbreviated history of feminist performance art. This became Once More with Feeling, a one-day event involving reenactments of numerous works from the late 1960s to the early 90s. The performances were both celebratory and unorthodox, evoking the past in today's terms. The event demonstrated the mixed feelings my generation has for the feminist artists who preceded us, while at the same time making our indebtedness and admiration transparent. In tying the work of second-wave feminist artists to our own artistic volition, we placed pleasure at the heart of our feminist concerns today.
We're working in response to Silver and Cameron, who made a piece called Angels and Overalls, where they constructed a wall in a park. And they also had a tent of different kind of facts about what women wear in the workplace.
They created a temporary archive, so that's the bit that we really took as inspiration. Mm-hmm. We've created a temporary archive, and we are creating a temporary archive. We're inviting members of the public to answer the question, what does feminism mean to you today? And then they're writing the responses on these rosettes, which are going to be displayed as a collection this evening.
In another attempt at redefining women's roles in public spaces, Lucy Thane embodied Betsy Damon's alter ego, the 7,000-year-old woman. In 1977, Damon invented this part clown, part ancient spring person, and inhabited her for 1 year, creating performances which revealed private rituals. Thane pranced around protective circles marked with flour and spices in front of the Tate's main entrance, just as Damon did before her in the streets of New York. My piece, entitled The Ties That Bind, included reenactments of a number of performances involving binding, a recurring metaphor in feminist performance art.
Okay, so I'd like to introduce you to my mom and dad. Come forward, Mom. Where's my father? And they're here this evening to reenact a performance you might be familiar with by Linda Montano and Dutch Shane Shea. They tied themselves together on a rope for 1 year. And so my parents, they were married in what year? 71. And they have been divorced since 82.
Disabled people are contagious.
From the perspective of contemporary disability politics, Katherine Araniello revisited Martha Rossler's 1975 Vital Statistics, a diatribe against the scientific standardization of physique and gender.
Above standard.
Using irony and humor, Araniello's piece emphasized the absurdity of using another's standards to judge oneself.
Vagina 30.6.
The female body will always remain mystery, no matter how many you see or how much knowledge you can achieve. You can never really demystify a cervix.
For this reworking of Judy Chicago's 1971 Cock and Cunt play, I exchanged outdated gender stereotypes for current ones and added in some advice from the sexologist and performance artist, Annie Sprinkle.
If I can ask everyone in the room, please, to join in. Don't worry, not in that, but just to join in one deep breath.
I masturbate with raw liver. I put it back in the fridge. The very next day, I serve it up to my girlfriend.
Caroline Smith borrowed the format of Bobby Baker's 1988 drawing on a mother's experience, but changed the content to address the public's relationship with food. Baker's work had entailed telling her own anecdotes of motherhood, while spilling ingredients onto a canvas on the floor. Smith's piece regurgitated the eating secrets of others, while similarly spattering their visceral contents onto her canvas. Lilibeth Cuenca Rasmussen's Nevermind Pollock invoked performances by Orlin, Yayo Kusama, Anna Mendieta, Carolee Schneeman, and Janine Antoni, connected through their expressive use of paint.
Vagina painting with a penis brush, female artists if themselves should trust, is it required to play as the male, to enter the game on a larger scale, paint the floor with hair and black, Janine Antoni aims set Polak, several arms were born out of his, Schneeman Kubota Linda Baglish.
Inspired by Eleanor Anton's cross-dressing in her 1977 film The King, Oreet Ashery collected hair from willing participants in order to disguise herself as a series of Middle Eastern politicians. She then continued to cover her face and body, becoming hairier and more wolfwoman-esque than Anton ever dared. Bringing images to life and updating their meaning in the process is another recurring theme I came across during my research. My piece Tableau Vivant reflects this and is an abbreviated history in and of itself.
What we have to do is seize our own cunts. Grab it firmly in both hands and proceed to announce what it is. That it's real.
It's real!